what you say.
Hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more.
Oh, woman, don't treat me so mean. You're the meanest old woman that I've ever seen. I guess if you say so, I'll have to pack my things and go.
Bless my soul, what's wrong with me? I'm itching like a man on a fuzzy tree. My friends say I'm acting wild as a bug. I'm in love, I'm all shook up. Ooh, ooh, yeah, yeah. Well, my hands are shaky and my knees are weak. I can't seem to stand on my own two feet. Who do you think of when you have such luck? I'm in love, I'm all shook up. Ooh, ooh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
If the crazy bees are final, if the crazy bees tell me what
Hey, I'm Christina Henry. I'm here with PKRG-TV, and I'm here with Hank.
O'Brien.
Hank O'Brien. Hi.
How you doing?
My wife is involved with the Greater Pascack Valley Women's Club, who help out with this show since inception.
I do believe this car behind us belongs to you.
Yes, it does. It's a 1946 Mercury convertible, full frame-off restoration.
What made you decide to purchase this one?
Well, it's an actually interesting story. Back in the 70s, there was a thing called the gas crisis. And a friend of mine owned a car, and he had started taking it apart. But he owned a gas station, and he went bankrupt because he couldn't get enough gas. So in an effort to help him out, I purchased the car. So we're just good friends. We're still friends to this day. So I brought it home three separate trips because it was in boxes, jars. The whole body was off the car. The front nose was in a different garage. 30
That's a
years.
Task.
Well, it was okay. It was a lot of fun. So I stored it for the 30 years. And during the course of that 30 years, I also bought many, many, many parts in order to do the restoration.
Sounds like a fun project, honestly.
Well, it was. It was actually a very, very good project. So starting somewhere around 2001, I spent 6 years building the car from the ground up. We took everything off the chassis, powder coated the chassis, and then started building the car from that point. And that's what you see today.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
So
Thank
beautiful.
You. Well, right next to it is a 1966 Mustang coupe with a 289 high performance engine in it. That car also was purchased many years ago out of Phoenix, Arizona. It's a rust-free car, originally six-cylinder. And what I did was take everything out of it, put in the 289 engine, and then basically reinforced and put heavy-duty everything in it. Probably another 2.5 years to build it. But it's a lot of fun. The building is what I really like.
Can you tell us a little bit about that color?
Actually, that's a very special Ford color called Cayman. Back in the late 70s, Ford would produce Cayman package cars. And I like the color because depending on how the sun hits it, it could be a dark blue, a light blue, green, multiple colors. A lot of fun.
It's like several cars in one.
Without a doubt. Absolutely.
That's awesome.
Thank you very much.
I just want to thank you
for letting
me interview you.
Taking the time. I appreciate it very, very much.
All right. That's lovely. Thank you.
Thanks. Thank you, Park Ridge.
As I walk along, I wonder.
so strong. And as I still walk on, I think of the things we've done together.
You know what I want to know about is the tickets. What are the tickets about?
The tickets are for a lot of wonderful prizes that local vendors have donated. There's gift cards to restaurants, I think your beauty salons, bottles of wine, all kinds of real goodies.
Goodies.
Goodies and goodies and more goodies.
Yeah, arm's length potato.
Coming out here
on this brisk weather and volunteering your time because we need dedicated people like
you.
Thank you.
All right,
thank you.
Bye.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived, and I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off you. Pardon the way that I stare. There's nothing. The sight of you leaves me weak. There are no words left to speak. But if you feel like I feel, please let me know that it's real. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off you.
What is your name?
My name is Matt Maizano of Motorcar Manor.
All right. Hi, Matt. So, this car behind us, can you tell us a little bit about it?
Sure. It's a Dodge Demon. They made 3,300 of them. This is actually car number 29 that was produced, so it's an early production. It has 840 horsepower with race gas. And on just pump gas, it has 808 horsepower.
Tell me a little bit more about when you purchased it and why you came to make that decision.
Well, so I'm a drag racer at heart.
Okay.
And I wanted to get the fastest production vehicle ever made. So I ordered this vehicle about a year in advance. And Luckily, I was able to get one. A lot of people, unfortunately, weren't able to, but I was able to get one, and I plan on racing it. It's supposed to do the quarter mile in 9.6 seconds. Hopefully, in the next couple of weeks, we'll see if we can match that.
I see. Oh my goodness, those tires are so clean. That's why. It's because it's a racing car. I get it. Okay. So you like to go fast?
I do. Yeah. And this car is pretty special. Aside from the horsepower and how fast it can go, it's the first car to ever come with drag radials. Drag rails aren't exactly the greatest tire to drive on the street, but they were able to do that. Also, it came with a line lock. So essentially, when you're drag racing, it locks the brakes up front so you can leave a nice burnout and get good grip. So it's also the first car that can offer that. So yes, I like my cars fast, and it's pretty cool that I don't have to do anything to it, and it will go.
Wow, I really would love to see that. That's something, oh my God, I know that we're not doing that today, but oh man, oh my God, that sounds exciting. Okay, well, thank you so much for letting me interview you, and enjoy the car show.
All right, thank you very much.
I've got to forget on the disco ride. Oh, yeah. Oh, I love the nightlife. I've got to forget on the disco ride. Oh, yeah. Please don't talk about love tonight. Please don't talk about sweet love. Please don't talk about being true.
Christina with PKRG-TV.
What is your name, sir?
Barry Monopoly.
Barry Monopoly.
With a Model A Ford here.
A Model A Ford. Now, tell us a little bit about this car and when it was made and when you got it.
Okay, the car is a 1929 Model A Ford. Henry Ford built the car as a roadster pickup, which is very rare because they build them out of California because of the weather. In this part of the country, East Coast, they made coupes. But they never made roadsters here. They were all from California. And my dad got me this car through someone when I was younger, and I put it on the road probably when I was about 16 or 17 years old, maybe a little bit older, 18. And I drove it till 2010. It was a different color. And I decided to restore it and make it a little safer for the road. And here it is. This is what it is now.
That is beautiful.
Yeah,
I love when people restore their cars. It really means that they care. They really put their blood, sweat, and tears into it. Can you tell us a little bit about how you have your car adorned today?
Well, as far as what it is, I normally have it dressed up for Halloween because I have both a witch and a ghost inside the car, but the wind has been a little heavy today, so they're both inside just relaxing in the warmer car.
Keeping warm, okay.
Right. I come to the show because it's a great show and it's a good cause.
This is a good foundation. It's for care for breast cancer.
And I try to support it every year. This is the third year I think I've been here. I appreciate everything. And like I said, it's a good cause, and it's good to support different causes.
Well, I thank you so much.
All right, thank you very much, too.
Well, it's a one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready. Now go, 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 but don't you step on my blue suede shoes. Well, you can do anything but take the help of my blue suede shoes. Well, it's blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Yeah! Blue, blue, blue suede shoes, baby. Blue, blue, blue suede shoes. Well, you can do anything but take the help of my blue suede shoes. Thank you.
drive, man.
All right, number two, second place, pre-1950s, car number 18, a 1946, a Mercury, a convertible, hey? First place in the pre-1950s, car number 92, the 1937 Plymouth, car number 92.
92.
Car number 104, the 1994 Buick Roadmaster, Paul.
Congratulations. Very well.
First place in the 2000 to 2009, car number 65, is a 2003 Mustang Cobra. Bob.
Very well. Don't forget your photo. That's the best part of the show. No.
Car number 20, 2014 Chevy Corvette.
Congratulations, man.
Second place, import. Car number 40, the 1937 Ford Royale.
Vintage.
All right,
yeah.
Congratulations.
First place import. Car number 99. It's a 1971 Volkswagen. Arthur!
Chevy Camaro.
Hey!
That's why I told you to stay.
All right, up next is the Corvettes. Third place goes to car number 22. This is a 1991 Vet K. Car number 6, 1964, Austin Healy.